I've been waiting for it to happen for a long time. Nunu is the most annoying. Actually, Ryze is the most annoying, but he's temporary annoying. Nunu is long-time annoying, and he just counter-jungles. He facilitates so well, gets you in and out of sticky situations. And as I said when we were watching game one, he steals your buff, and then there's no point even hitting
him. Yeah, he also unlocks the Azir and the Jinx, and those sort of carries that are being quite popular. Even Lucian, who's fairly popular, benefits from the Blood Boil as well. So I agree, I like to ban a lot. Hecarim actually banned from Avant-Garde as their last. Alistar gonna eat it there as well, so no Alistar for Avant-Garde either. And one left now for Legacy.
Yeah, Destiny plays Alistar really well. He's Roam, and honestly, his mid-game presence, not even his support that he brings, is super high. Other champion that he does it well on is Thresh, so we'll have to see whether that one gets taken away, because generally, when they're able to get Destiny roaming around the map trying to make plays for the team, Avant look very good.
They have, and it's just been, again, Chelby sort of being on form, even on champions like Sejuani, much more team fighting than we've seen. Is that Cho'Gath finally eats a ban?
Yeah, I am not surprised at all. It's just something that Kensi plays incredibly well. Safe in the laning phase, farms incredibly well. It's hard to stop him from getting to 2-3 items when all that CDR comes through. The bite's just on much too short of a cooldown to be able to deal with, so they take it away. And what you mentioned on Chelby there is so critical for this Avant lineup. He's had flashes of brilliance in the past. He had the best 5 minutes of Lee Sin play at finals when they were able to come through. Sorry, I think that was summer finals and win it. But honestly, if he continues to play calm, consistent League of Legends, he's an incredibly strong jungler. It's his decision-making in the past that's let him down, never his mechanic. And if he can keep that very tight, this Avant lineup looks incredibly scary on the top side of the map.
They do. And they're going to start things off with a good pick there for Chelby, you have to think. Gragas going to be the first pick. Seen this so many times. Such a popular first pick.
Yeah, I don't even think you need to say it anymore. Gragas just does everything. I'm not surprised to see him come through first. And also gives nothing away from the comp. We just saw Soul Strikes go huge on Gragas with ganking presence in lane, farms really quickly, so yeah, he just does it all right. Yeah, now.
Good stuff. Rek'Sai open, of course, if Carbon wants to take it, but Carbon does like to stick it to the enemy jungle. It's sort of funny. Chelby and Carbon, classically as a matchup in the region, have always been very aggressive. They like to get in each other's face, duel in the jungle, take other camps, and kind of really just get inside each other's head.
Yeah, it was really good when they were playing Lee Sin and Rengar, respectively. Chelby, huge Lee Sin player. Carbon was a very good Rengar player coming through there, so see whether that is something that ever comes through again, because I used to like those days.
I did too, but instead, with a lot of Cinderhawk champions running around, we'll start with Nautilus and Kalista actually coming through for Tallywhacker.
Yeah, so Tally always been a very good Kalista player since she was released, likes to pick up the new champions and do work with them. Nautilus just so good with the kit. A little bit more aggressive than what Thresh Kalista is. Of course, they have the double leap away with the Kalista ultimate than Thresh landing, so they're a safer lane. But as far as bully lanes go, Nautilus with the spammable E just does remarkable damage for a support.
He does. And I think for me, it's also how good Nautilus's ultimate is against Kalista. So I sort of like the duo there that they picked away. But Avant, of course, have plenty of picks for themselves to make. You mentioned the Destiny Thresh. They will at least give it a look here. Wouldn't be too surprised to see that one coming in. But Avant, they've been interesting with their drafts, I say, but still strong in their team play. So I'm curious to see if this is what they want here. Going to take a couple more seconds, but lo and behold, Warble. The Sivir main is going to go to Ashe to pair with that Thresh.
Yeah, so I think the second Ashe that we've seen, I think Denny imported out in one of his games. That didn't go too well, but Ashe incredibly strong in the current meta coming through. Good lane bully potential with, of course, just the ability to be able to volley lanes repetitively. Very spammable. Has the global now on the E to give extra vision. And one thing that Ashe does that no other AD carry really does is just start team fights off screen. The arrow is absolutely massive. So if they ever get someone in a pickable situation, they can just fire the Ashe arrow at them. If it hits, all the follow-up that can come through from the Gragas, from the Thresh, means that if you don't have vision of this Avant lineup and you try and face check anything, they will kill you incredibly quickly.
And we've seen a lot of that from Avant recently, but Legacy going to respond with the Rek'Sai there for Carbon, and Choo-Choo's back on the Victor train.
So this is what I was going to say next. I'm surprised they went with Gragas if they wanted to play Ashe, because Rek'Sai, you can't face check against, because the Tremor Sense is just ridiculously good if people are moving. So all of a sudden, it's only brush camps that you can really set up to catch people out, because as long as Carbon is burrowed scouting the area, he should be able to keep his team safe from something like an offset pick.
Yeah, I mean, they've got plenty of good CC as well. Nautilus, of course, getting in range can really rack Ashe. That's always been her one problem. You get on top of her, she dies instantly.
Yeah, but she's kind of like Kalista at the moment, in the sense that her kite is that good that if you don't kill her in the CC that you catch her in. She's just incredibly hard to pin down after that. With the augmented Q that comes through, just all the arrows flying everywhere. Yep. I don't even know what it's called.
Ranger's Focus.
Yep. There you Whatever go. That is, it does heaps of damage.
It does.
Yeah, so it's hard to get away from Ash right now.
It is indeed. As Avant going to round things up pretty normally by the looks of things. Not going to be in the top for Porky. Not the Rumble this time, but LeBlanc back for Kenstu.
Yeah, so going with an Assassin. We spoke about the pick potential that can come through. You need a little bit of CC, which is what the Gnar, he will keep them there after the Ash Arrow. But Kenstu, they're legitimately looking to single out one member of the Legacy lineup. Right now, I'm thinking Victor because he's very immobile. Shoot an arrow at him and then kill him. And that's why Choo Choo's is hovering cleanse, because that's the only way he can get out of all this CC.
I think that's a great spell choice against Ash in particular. I guess the other thing I like on Avant's side with the Ash is actually the Gregor Salty. Yeah. You catch him with the arrow, get away.
Yeah, exactly.
Everyone else, not the guy you ulted. Yeah, that's bad
news. In between the team. Yeah. So you can knock them further towards your team, push everyone else back. Completely agree with pick comps. It's always been a good choice. The other thing about the LeBlanc matchup right now is just really important to break Tether the first time. So the cleanse isn't even going to be bad during the laning phase for Choo, so it's something that is a good laning pick as well. And wow, Minky Whale goes back to Aurelia.
It's been a while.
This was a permaban against him when he had his first stint on the lineup, because he plays it incredibly
well. He does. We've sort of seen Minky. He's a very aggressive player. Like, Minky's a lot of things for Legacy. It feels like sometimes he's, you know, the dad. He's the emotional support. He's certainly the one that keeps their spirits up. But man, when he's going forward, that's when he's happiest. The Whale does not like to be behind.
No, he certainly doesn't. And you know, when, if you look at the Legacy lineup, and they're stacked in regards to talent, but if there's one person you want with farm, it's probably Minky right now, because he is such a good momentum player. He gets ahead, you can nearly guarantee he will translate that to other parts of the map. And we've seen him on the likes of Hecarim, Diana go absolutely mental this split already. So giving him a carry into a counter matchup, players love taking Aurelia into Gnar, does incredibly well. It's just going to be in Minky Whale's favor.
And I think this top lane is an awesome one to watch here, because it's two very skilled top laners, especially in that laning phase with Porky and Minky. And Minky's Aurelia, again, you said it was famous, very famous last split when he was playing subtle late there as well. Can't wait to see it again against Porky.
Yeah, and you know, you can't not mention Chelby and Carbon in this matchup, because you think with how volatile Minky will play that top lane, they'll either swap on him, because players don't like playing one-on-one versus Minky Whale right now because of his laning phase. It's kind of sporadic. He plays very aggressive. And so if you're up there to counter gank, it will do good things for you.
It will indeed, as we look at the team comps for the first time here as we load into the game. But of course, get on Twitter and use those hashtags and let us know who you think is going to win the game. Use hashtag AVWin for Avant with their fancy Kenstu LeBlanc skin that he loves for some reason. Don't know why he likes that skin. Or hashtag LGCWin for Legacy and the Whale playing Aurelia.
Yeah, so no skin coming through from Minky Whale, which is weird because Aurelia has some of the best skins
in
the game.
She does. She has great skins here, but not coming through this time. I really, like, I don't know why Kenstu likes that LeBlanc skin. He always uses it.
Yeah.
It annoys me.
Yeah.
Green Ash. It's whatever. It's fine. As you can see, I think Warble and Ash, despite the silly colors, is actually really cool. Because, again, he's a Sivir player, is more of a utility carry there as well. But Warble does have sort of hard carry blood running through his veins. So the fact he's willing to take Ash, a very supportive AD carry, and sort of trust the rest of his team to carry around him, is kind of really cool to see.
Yeah, and you know, you talk about Sivir, very good press R AD carry. Ash, also a very good press R AD carry. If you hit a prioritized target with your arrow able to take them out, it doesn't even really matter if you exist or not, because you've neutralized a threat. So definitely has a supportive element to her kit, does very good damage in the late game, especially Ash always has because of her ability to kite. Rip, Ghost Flash,
yep, Ash. Not good.
Ash, it was great. I miss it. But on the other lineup, it really, that's why Minky Whale's Aurelia pick is just so good right now, because with Merc Treads in team fights, he's going to be able to negate a lot of that CC that Ash is going to be there for. It's why we used to see Aurelia. Her job is to catch the arrow, as it were, in this team comp, and then really try and steamroll the backline to the point where the likes of Chelby, the likes of Porky, they're not trying to dive carries. They're trying to peel back and deal with Minky Whale on this Aurelia, who's going to be very hard to lock down.
Yeah, dealing with Aurelia, especially Minky's Aurelia when he gets ahead, not an easy task at all. So the onus really on almost the top laners in this matchup in a lot of different ways, to really get things going. We've seen what happens when a Gnar can get big in a game and really start to carry and get those big ulties off in Mega Gnar form. It's going to be a tough matchup across the board. I think for me, I still haven't quite figured out why Victor's seeing so much play, because sort of like Tristana, he's the other big Oceanic champion.
Yeah, Victor, you know, he has seen some other play in regions, like NA play him a little bit as well. He's got a pretty solid laning phase coming through there. His wave clear is really good. The one danger of him is if you ever fight near a wall and Victor's on the other side of it, you will die. He kills people over walls really well. That's the one thing about Victor. You have to be aware of terrain, because if he drops the ultimate and the gravity field over the wall, he just destroys you. Mm-hmm. So I like the way people play Victor currently. It's like an assassin that also has good poke potential that can come out of the laser beam. But I agree with you. He is very immobile. That is his biggest weakness. Like, he stands in one spot and then he doesn't move very quickly anywhere. Even with the Q, he's only a burst of speed coming through, kind of like Ahri, but without three dashes. So I agree with you. He has a very clear weakness. And if he ever gets Gnar ulted in this game, he's a sitting duck.
Yeah, I mean, Gnar ult, Ash Arrow without the cleanse coming through. There's lots of problems potentially here for Two Shoes, but we've seen his positioning immaculate. He's laning excellent there as well. So should be just fine there in the mid lane. Tallywhacker's Kalista might be the last highlight, though. Wobble's Ash is already pretty cool, but Tally back on a big playmaking carry.
Yeah, and you know the all-in potential with Kalista coming up against the Ash. If he's able to get level 2, level 3, good damage through there, that's going to be an incredibly rough lane for Wobble, because if anything, this is probably the champion that Tallywhacker defaults back to. We've seen the Tristana, we've seen the Ezreal, we've seen Varus, but yeah, he's very, very good at Kalista.
He is. And Tally, I mean, he was a top lane player for a while. I think a Riven specialist in some ways there as well. Loves his mechanically intensive, kind of very hardcore, really hard to play champions. As far as AD carry champions go, Kalista's right at the top.
Yeah, he single-handedly forced Rumble out of the meta for a while in the top lane with his Riven play, because you just couldn't take it against him. Now, very mechanically heavy AD carry. Let's see if he can get some work done.
And Legacy, they need a win here, honestly. Didn't get one in the week earlier on against Immunity. Avant looking for an undefeated week here as well. So lots to play here for both sides here. Some pretty cool picks are going to be in our last game of the night.
Yeah, and you see 5-point defense coming through right now for Avant. They don't want to get invaded on Legacy. They're stacking into the bottom wave, maybe looking to see whether they can catch Destiny out, although he has spotted them.
Yep, has seen them already, so not going to get them just yet here. Minky leading the charge here as Legacy get through. Actually, no Trinket Ward there in the Tribush. Only a couple Trinkets being put down right now. So Deep Vision will come through. Destiny finally going to ward as they rotate in, as Tally just gets one auto attack on it, because why not here? And again, might be just scouting for the lane swap.
Yeah, and that's a weird ward coming through from Destiny, because he won't actually see them exit if they do from that side of the jungle. So right now, Legacy kind of don't have to move anywhere.
Oh, they got the ward. Wobble and Destiny with a team up there. That was very cute positioning from the Ash.
Yeah, it certainly was. You see mass recalls coming through from Legacy. They do want the lane swap. They're heading top, pinging out a ward. See whether on the bottom side. No, they're actually calling the bluff and staying bottom.
Yeah, I mean, it's funny because Legacy, I think, can still just see Destiny down the bottom side. So if they wanted the 2v2, it looks like they're going to get it. I mean, this is Wobble's counterpick, don't forget, as well. So I believe he's at least comfortable in the matchup. But I think AD carries, especially Tallywhacker here, going to be very integral to how this game plays out. So we'll see what happens in the bottom side. But for me, I'm very happy for standard lanes, because Minky versus Porky in this matchup is a treat.
Yeah, that's the one that I've been looking forward to as well. We'll see whether Porky, who had to blind pick, can deal with the counter pick that came through there. The one thing I will say is I haven't seen how Black Cleaver does against Aurelia. I'm assuming it's still not fantastic, but we'll see whether he can make it work.
We'll have to see as jungle camp's going to get started by Carbon, but Minky actually didn't take a camp. I think Porky might have got a slight amount of experience, but he's going to come up to the top as well. He'll walk there though. Minky will have to use his teleport, but other than that, nothing really major happening in the early levels.
Yeah, so Minky grabbed an extra potion and burnt teleport for it, looking to get ahead early, but I think he missed a melee minion, which is going to not be great if Gnar can get level 2 early.
Started Blade Surge though, so able to get the creeps right in the back there, but again, range versus melee, at least as far as mini Gnar versus Aurelia goes, does have to be a little careful trying to CS the back line.
Yeah, and it's going to get to a point where he'll probably go Tabi first, just to shrug off a lot of the damage, and then he'll just try and Blade Surge, get damage done within his E ratio like Aurelia's like to, and trade incredibly efficient.
Yeah, and that was sort of the matchup before, and we saw it. It's a good dodge from Wobble. Gets out of the way of the hook there from Flying Jew, but level 2 hit by all four members of the bottom lane fairly quickly, and I think this is a lot about how this matchup works out. Wobble just wants to not eat hooks and keep farming away.
Yeah, exactly right. All Ash, once again, like, funnily enough, like AP Cogmore, is just happy for neutrality until level 6. From there, try and set up ganks with the ultimate coming through, but Kalista, anything but, very loaded kit, wants to kill you early in the game.
Carbon's gotten quite low on his red buff, actually, but will be safe. Used his smite pretty aggressively, but able to clear it out. He hit level 3, might have enough there as he pops back into the burrow with the health regen to take out the raptors, and gets low, but he'll be fine. Carbon, maybe a bit aggressive on the runes there.
Yeah, I think what he did is he actually smote the Gromp and then gave it over to his bottom lane. So he didn't get level 2 off it because that's why Tally and Ju were able to hit level 2 first, even though Warble and Destiny took the Krugs. So they definitely had a camp to themselves, but in regards to that, Carbon just went a little bit lower. Lucky he wasn't invaded.
Yeah, good guy Carbon though. Helping his bottom lane out. Goes back and gets himself a Ranger's Trailblazer. Tally hits the first hook in the lane actually. And Destiny, a wonderful double flay comes through. Warble coming in for the damage, forcing the flash. Destiny though going in there, needs the damage down. Warble doesn't quite have enough yet. First blood goes to Destiny. Lands in there for Warble. Might be enough.
Oh my
Flays
goodness.
Him out of it as well. And Destiny played that so well.
Yeah, he certainly did. And that's the danger of ever fighting a Thresh. His auto attacks do work early game coming in there. Destiny able to come up with the kill. Warble, they prioritize the AD carry, which is so important in this matchup. You will see Ju try and freeze this lane, which is good things for Legacy, but First Blood still going over.
And Tallywhacker, he's always aggressive, it feels like. We want to see this again.
Yeah, so Destiny goes in, gets a very good play, and from there, Tally has to burn everything to try and get away. You see the heal go down as well, but just wasn't enough to get him out of there. Destiny able to pick it up. And then the shield came through. And this denying play was just absolutely huge. Make sure he takes up creep aggro as well, which is something that you don't normally see from support players. They leave you to the wolves in that regard. But able to do everything perfectly.
Yep, played it wonderfully and gives him a CS lead and the first blood, of course, and even another assist as Carbon now diving into the mid side once Kensty, and he's going to flash away to safety.
Oh, but he takes a lot of return damage, which means Kensty might be safe for a little bit longer, although Oom probably has to back.
Minky though against Porky, Megan are already up, and Porky getting good trade damage down, no level 6, so can't come in with the ulti, but Minky loses a big trade there in top.
Yeah, he certainly does, but he has a lot of sustain through the flask as well as 4 health potions that he started with, and he's W, so he's going to be completely fine. And honestly, this is what Minky wants to do. Farm unharassed, get to the point where he has his boots and maybe the making of a Phage and Sheen, something like that, and then he would just start outright winning trades. Aurelia, very annoying because of her high sustain.
Yeah, I mean, Hitem style gets those points up. Equilibrium Strike, I think got a small nerf relatively recently, so usually maxes that instead, and you can see 3 points already. Minky, much like Vladimir, hits level 9, going to be A-okay.
Yeah, he certainly is, especially people sometimes still max Equilibrium Strike just because it's a better trading tool, especially against Gnar, but going, wow, Carbon.
Yep. For a gank, actually, as Carbon joins into the top side, but Porky reads that one pretty easily, hops himself away in the mini now, and now Chelby actually going to rotate himself
yeah,
up.
Yeah, I was going to say, they need to be careful because this lane is reversing really quickly, so Minky, he needs to shove it quickly with help of his jungler or just go back because Chelby loves to gank when your lane's stacking up.
He does. I mean, Chelby, we've already seen it, lots of setup ganks. It's been honestly fairly quiet so far, but you can see Minky level 6 now. Porky also level 6, building up some rage. This is going to be a nice setup for a dive.
Yeah, they want to dive here, which is weird. Porky actually shoved the wave back instead of letting it push out.
Coming in now onto Minky, ultimate of the watch. Shelby comes through, but Minky survives it there and Blade Surge is away.
Yeah, able to get a lot of life back through 2 people with the Blade Surge as well. Remember, it gives you more healing if you hit champions, and now big wave, but they're not going to be able to finish the dive.
Big wave indeed, and did Minky even get stunned there? Because his passive did so much work if he did.
No, he actually dashed through and didn't get hit by the wallop. He got hit by the Gnar, but that was it. So nothing else coming through to CC him up.
Makes sense there. So strong stuff from Minky as Choo-Choo's and Kensty getting a little precarious here in the mid lane, but they'll trade some damage back and forth. Doran's Rings here, so no potions left for either of them as Wobble down the bottom side. Gonna get grabbed up by Flying Jupiter Lantern, keeps him safe.
Yeah, and not getting hit by the Pierce either, so no damage coming through from Tallywhacker, and they're farming pretty consistently in this bottom lane and not in much danger of dying.
No, and again, Ash wants to keep the lane neutral. Doesn't have summoners up quite yet, but Pickaxe going to make farming and trading that much easier. Kensty sort of in the same spot. I think they're just trying not to get killed here in the mid lane for the most part. And Carbon actually going to clear this out. Legacy might look to start their first dragon.
Yeah, trying to get this one done. They traded ultimates in the mid lane. Choose a little bit higher health, but of course, Kensty's ultimate going to be available with much better frequency. So Choose still needs to be careful. Good timing of doing the dragon with blue buff here means that Kensty can't contest if he wants to pick up his blue. So Tallywhacker will be able to chunk that one out.
Yep, no vision there either. And Legacy are going to be the first ones to pick up a dragon. So Avant, 1,000 gold ahead actually after that kill. And of course, remember guys, if you're in that competition, I hope you got that last dragon.
Yeah, make sure you screenshot that one. And seeing Avant, they gave it up without much of a contest. Not really surprising coming through there. They do want Porky to be able to contest these ones, and Porky just wasn't in a position to fight. But he has gone double Durant, which means he is very committed to winning this lane.
He is, and you could see already he was getting good trades down. He called up Chelby for a gank, but couldn't quite get it done. Minky, as you said, just trying to keep the farm up. Has his Phage now, so going to be scaling towards that Trinity Force here. And as Aurelia gets stronger, gets those levels, gets those items, it's going to get harder and harder for Porky to keep this Aurelia down.
And this is a confident Aurelia build, not going boots two for the rash, just going straight for the phage. Maybe it was a Giant's Belt purchase. I don't know whether he reactionary bought that, but not much harass will come through from Gnar. So he's just going straight for Trinity Force, seeing if he can get that huge mid-game spike.
Yep. Wobble as well, going to go back to get a few more early game items once his power spikes to start coming through. Also, Fiendish Codex completed there for Kenstian. Looks like Chutu's upgrading that Hex Core to start things off. So some early itemization coming through. Sightstone's finished up for supports there as well. But other than that, just some trades on the top side as Minky going aggressive and Porky's now the one forced away.
Yeah, not able to get in there and using the Blade Surge nicely to get minions low so he can use the Blade Surge with the reset. Once again, just solid mechanics coming through from both top laners, and it looks to be very back and forth.
Yeah, that was the Minky Whale special, I feel like, when we saw his Aurelia last time. Always surfing on top of those minions, clearing them out with the ultis. So good looking stuff. There is Porky going to AoE down the minion waves in Mega Gnar form as well. And just what we expected from these two top laners, just efficient trading back and forth and bounce so close.
Yeah, but Minky honestly starting to get the upper hand in that lane, and you feel that across the board, Legacy may be starting to stress out an advantage in mid lane as well as top, but slightly losing bottom because of that first blood.
Yeah, Kensty getting pushed out quite heavily, actually. So Avant trying to pressure advantage in the other stages, pressure advantage in the bottom side, sorry, with two other lanes under a little bit of stress. Tallywhacker, though, returns down. BF
they want to kill Chu so bad now that Ash is level 6.
Oh, Wobble. Finally, the roaming AD carry, what we've always wanted here. I mean, there's no dragon, so it's certainly the mid laner's Minky. Still winning these trades in the top side.
Yeah, and there's three members up there. Porky needs to be careful. Does have ultimate back available for Mega Gnar, but is still in a very real diveable position.
Good wards as well, actually. Would have spotted it off by the looks of things. Carbon, though, gets a knockup. Porky's going to flash away. He is Mega. He crunches away. And Shoes, you just can't chase any of that.
But once again, it's just the little things. That will give a wave over to Minky Whale and maybe burn the teleport as well. Not to mention the mid lane pressure that they seeded to get that gank coming through. So probably an advantage of Avant.
I think so. I mean, again, Wobble keeping the lane, even actually still ahead on CS in the bottom side. Actually went boots two after that pickaxe, so wants a little more mobility maybe against those hooks, but again, just content to farm the lane out as mid tower goes to Avant.
Yeah, potentially as Chu's now looking to get aggressive on Kensty.
I mean, he's got his ulti. He doesn't need to do too much more, but not quite in range again. Victor, woefully short-ranged.
Yeah, he certainly is not able to get anything done down there, and the boots two pickup, that's different coming through from Wobble. I think it is what you mentioned, just the defensive qualities of the extra speed as Kensty now being dove.
Carbon coming in, but Chelby here to defend the tower. Maybe actually going to try and move it off. Chelby clears him out with the barrel on the Gragas, but Legacy continuing to pressure. Choo Choo just mowing down the waves with the Death Ray.
Yeah, able to just continually shove in there. You saw that they bought Porky there as well, just to see whether the dive was going to be completed there onto the jungler. Everything resetting, and honestly, a very quiet early game that Avant has steadily built a gold lead in.
Yeah, I mean, they've got the first kill. They lost that dragon, so a bit of a trade-off there. Tower actually going to them as well in the mid lane, so a good rotation after Chuchu's tried to roam top does lead them to a decent gold lead here. But that first kill, they were sitting at 1,000 gold ahead. Again, sitting in these lands, making sure they get their farm, just playing very patiently.
Yeah, and one thing I need to point out is the fact that there is a 15 CS advantage right now for Chelby.
Oh, flying Jew, it's a hook there, but nothing else coming out of it. And Chelby, you're right, being a very different Chelby than we saw maybe in the middle of last year here. We've talked about it. He's really changed from being a hyper-aggressive jungler to just being much more rounded in his play.
And you know, these tanks, as soon as they get any semblance of farm, just become such trouble to deal with, especially for the Kalista in the mid game. Having to chunk through a tank Gragas is not going to be a good thing. And Chelby, he's just trying to farm up a storm and get an advantage through not ganking lanes this time, but just the pure CS.
Yeah, he's just been farming up, ganking where appropriate, taking some farm to sort of cover those lanes. Is flying Jewy to hook. Destiny might ride it in. Does find the flay here. Box not going to get used. Tally returns. The ulti, though, for Wobble comes in. And there's the counter ulti's coming through. Depth Charge moves in. Fate Score comes in as well. Chelby now here trying to get them off. Box goes down. Ulti there is good from Chelby, but Tally takes out Destiny. Minky flashes away, and Chelby, he wants it so bad. He will get it, but he might die as a result. That damage is done. Wobble moving back in, but gets hooked by Jewy. Choo, and that's all Tally needs as Kensi comes down, gets one kill, gonna try and make it two, but Tallywhacker jumping around everywhere. Kensi dives back in, actually gets himself the kill as Choo Choo's takes out Gragas under the turret. Actually, Kensi's still alive though, didn't go down quite yet. Prey Seeker will land, Tether will come in as well, but Choo Choo's cleans up the double.
Yeah, and that was all through a teleport advantage. You see, Porky was able to grab a turret, now pushing in on the second one. So honestly, 3-for-2, still in AV's favor, and this is something that we keep coming back to. They're moving around the map a little bit better. Minky had the right idea. He saved that bottom lane 2v2, but they just weren't able to get enough to make it worthwhile.
No, and a nice pinpoint warble ultimate starts it off. So the first arrow looking good there for Ash as Destiny comes through to clean these waves out. But let's see this crazy fight again.
Yeah, so they know they have the teleport advantage. Tally smartly stops his recall and Warble gets chunked out. He has to burn everything. Minky joins the fight, goes a little bit too deep, takes a turret shot on the back end of this, I believe. Yeah, and that's what killed him there. Shelby able to chase him down with that Cinderhulk. And from there, it was just all about LeBlanc beating him into the bottom lane, but Dragon has been started.
Yeah, it's all about Dragon right now. Second does fall to Legacy, so maybe have that as a win condition they can look to. Juke, very nice there from Carbon. Gets out from the hook, but Destiny flays him instead. Shelby gets the knock-up, and Porky hops on his face for the kill.
Yeah, so able... Wow, the
ulti
marrow.
Ulti onto Juke. Fate's call not up now for Tallywhacker. It's very close. Does use it there and able to get him to safety. But a close call there for Nautilus.
Yeah, they start zoning off the minion wave as well. Porky probably going to be able to steal away the blue buff. Get that over onto one of the carries. Might even take it himself if he wants it.
Might. Shelby wants it. Who's going to get it? It resets. That's a bit awkward.
Yeah, Shelby. No one's going to get it.
No, no one this time. Too many hard leeches there. Shelby, though, going to stay to clean it up.
Yeah, that is the tankiest blue buff I've seen in a while.
He's very manly. Is Shelby going to collapse some tunnels, get some wards down as Minky in the top side, able to get his team a turret.
Yeah, so they're able to equalize top lane turrets. That's now not meaning too much of an advantage. They blew a lot of ultimates in the bottom lane once again, but no kills going down. And one this game, honestly, on a knife edge still. Either team up for grabs at 15 minutes in. Legacy have the Dragon advantage, but a slight gold advantage still in Avant's favor.
Yeah, and getting stronger are Avant as well. Porky going for the tank item, so just the Doran's for Lena, no other damage items coming through. Melanomicon completed for Kensti, who's got a blasting one for any number of items.
And Abyssal coming through.
Oh, nice stuff though. I was going to say maybe Merktreads, but I think you're right, it is Abyssal.
Yeah, so he'll be going for Abyssal, looking to use the human cannonball. LeBlanc, so entertaining to watch when you flash double distort on people, able to get out a fair distance as well. So look for him to try and launch himself onto those carries and snipe them.
I mean, there's a reason you do it. It does fairly insane damage in a nice short area. So I like it a lot from Kensi coming through. I think Abyssal Scepter, one of those items that if you can build on a mid laner now, is just great.
Carbon just burnt flash away from only Chelby.
I mean, look, he was very afraid.
Yeah, he was petrified.
I mean,
he burned a 5-minute cooldown against a Gragas.
I mean, Shelby, they've had a lot of history. Maybe assumed someone else had to be there despite
PTSD,
having two friends.
Yeah, just yeah, a little flashbacks.
I mean, those flashbacks Carbon will not enjoy. His Kensti going to get himself a blue buff. And as we're talking about, that Abyssal, if you can build it, it's just such a good item.
Yeah, it's just so cost efficient in both defensive and offensive stats coming through there. And there's still a lot of magic damage on the Legacy lineup. Have to deal with Ju. You're going to have to deal with Choo Choo. So it's not a horrible pickup.
Yeah. Choo Choo's might even be looking for the same item here. At least has a Negatron right now. Just
on
for
him,
the
I definitely agree with it because he is horribly short-ranged. Yeah. And LeBlanc at any stage has the option to launch onto Victor.
Well, we look at damage items on Legacy. We can look up there as well for Minky. He's actually finished his Trinity Force. So Power Spike through there. Bloodthirst it on for Tallywhacker. All of a sudden, that slim gold lead not looking so bad for Legacy.
Yeah, and it's just because Legacy have really smooth item curves coming through. That's the thing about Kalista. She's got a very efficient two-item buy with Hurricane as well as Thirster. If she goes into any form of armor penetration like a Last Whisper after, it's still a very good build. And Minky, honestly, only needed his Trinity Force to get going in this game. Now that he's over there, Boots 2, Frozen Heart, probably the next things that he's going to look at.
And this is the part of the game where, and why people fear Minky's Aurelia, is Ju actually going to get ulted back in. That was a very interesting interaction. Keeps himself safe with the Q, but Tallywhacker on top of the Fates Call there as well. But another good bit of pressure. Warble still has his ulti as well.
Yeah, that was a cool interaction. It looked like Barrel beat Hook, but then Fates Call beat everything.
Yeah. I mean, that's the rule of Fates Call for sure, as Warble throws a Hawk down the lane just to get a bit more vision. Scrying Orb as well will scout them out. Minkywell does not have his telly just yet. And Avant, as a result, will get their third. No, not quite. Looking for their third tower, but don't quite claim it.
Yeah, everyone rotating into this bottom lane right now. You see LeBlanc as well as Victor. They're also hanging out. LeBlanc's trying to follow Victor and catch him in transit, try and see if she can delete him before he's able to get through there, but Turret will live for now, although Carbon's recalling probably will go down.
Porky hanging out also, finds Minky well, actually down in CS, but we'll catch up.
Actually, Carbon has ulti.
As it clears out this web, yeah, it is Rek'Sai.
This is going to be the never-ending story of bottom lane turrets.
I mean, if I want it, Chelvy doesn't have his ultimate, but there's a few too many threats here, so Carbon ulti's down, does not save the turret. And Dragons will be next look here. A minute 45 and Legacy, they're on track for their third quite swiftly.
Yeah, they certainly are. See whether they can set up. Carbon has gone for a Sightstone. On the other side of the map, you see Chelvy has the makings of a Frozen Heart. So he's going to be much more fight ready than what Carbon is. Carbon really is trying to ensure that Vision is up. Because as we keep mentioning, this AV lineup only needs that one pick from the Ash Arrow to be able to start everything in their favor.
Yeah, they've got LeBlanc as well, who loves when the enemy jungle is littered with wards and dark on their side. As Abyssal is now finished up for Kensi. Randy one's completed for Porky. Infinity Edge and Double Dagger actually done now for Warble. So things looking good for the early Yvonne. Item builds looking to contest for this next dragon.
Yeah, I want to see if that Double Dagger goes into a Phantom Dancer, which are probably... Wow.
Wow, arrow into Carbon there. Kensi dives in as well. Now the slow's coming through. Can't get away from Warble and a beautiful setup. For
yeah,
a kill.
What a good pick in the mid lane. Singling out the jungler. 50 seconds left. That ultimate on cooldown. Probably not enough time for Carbon to get back for this dragon.
No, it doesn't have his ult either, so definitely not enough time, I think. And Avant... Actually, no, it is up, not up quite yet, excuse me. So we'll have to see how that pans out. But Porky... clearing things out, got his teleport ready to come back down if he needs to be there. Frozen Heart completed for Chelvy is a massive pickup against his Kalista as well. So the pick's good for Avant, they're going to see what else they can get off it.
Yeah, and this is why Kalista started struggling in the meta, because both Sejuani and Gragas build Frozen Heart naturally because they like the mana on it as well as the cooldown reduction. And all of a sudden, Tally, he can throw as many spears as he wants into Gragas, but it's going to take a while to kill the fat man.
Well, Warble ate a couple, and that was not happy times, but keeping himself safe. Choo-choo's the next target, gets singled out in the jungle as Kensi and Chelvy back on form, it looks like.
Yeah, and you see the sweep is coming through early, the upgraded sweeper even for Destiny. They're controlling Vision around the blue buff. And once again, this is just a lineup that is terrifying to face check. You've got the LeBlanc for picks. Gragas, you've already mentioned how well he couples with it. Not to mention an Ash Arrow and a Thresh threat in the bottom lane. They get two picks, leads to the first dragon for them.
And I love the double pink quads. They had flanking that dragon as well. So no way for Legacy to get in, probably without dying. And Avant finally arrest control of the dragon. Keep that gold lead stacking up. And all of a sudden, almost 21 minutes in, oh, 3,000 gold up for Avant.
Yeah, so Avant, they're just going to slowly try and build the lead. On Legacy's lineup, they are really looking for Minky to save the game because he's 40 CS up. He's 0-1-2, which isn't a fantastic early score, but you can see going for probably a Randuin's Omen and some Merc Treads next. He's going to have a very good two-item build to try and dive onto Warble. And if they can get rid of one of the damage threats, it's relatively... not great damage coming out of the rest of Avant. No. They're not incredibly low because Gnar does more than a lot of top laners, but it's not an extremely high damage threat.
No, Kensi might struggle with Warble dead, especially. You said it already, Avant sort of need a pick here. Legacy instead will get a tower to try and answer some of the gold coming through. So 2-3 now in that particular objective, but Avant still leading in gold, still leading in kills, and with the last dragon starting to catch themselves up there as well. And for me, it's been Warble's hour, as we've wondered. It's the second Ash we've seen so far in the OPL this split. And his arrows have been on point so far.
Yeah, he laned it incredibly well, to be honest. He's 20 CS up, which is an incredible feat coming in here, and has just been able to avoid a lot of the aggression that Carbon was trying to put in his lane. Once again, credit to Chelvy to really be able to get in there and help his laners out this time.
You can see Kensi in the bottom side, although Minky caught Chelvy by the looks of things. Barrels come through. Minky going to chase in. Chelvy forced to ultimate there as Minky just throws the last dagger to send a message. And Choo-choo's in the mid lane clearing things up, but Warble's here to answer that. And Kensi, I love this from him in the bottom side. He's the split pusher now for the team.
Yeah, and this is something that LeBlanc feels a niche role in for about 5 more minutes, where she can still solo out people and kill them fairly easily. We'll be able to go head-to-head with the Kalista, even the Victor, and try and get people deleted. So I definitely agree. Smart move, map movements coming through here from Avant, relying on Warble to wave clear. Porky and Kensi still going to split push.
And it's one of those weird things where he's probably not going to get a tower out of it. He might get some damage down. He's probably not going to get a kill. In fact, if anything, he's maybe more at risk of dying just based on positioning if he makes a mistake. But it's so much extra gold that you wouldn't have got otherwise, and you basically buy time for everyone else and free up a lane in the map, that if you can afford to do it, it's such a beneficial thing.
Yeah, it's another soaking lane, because realistically, the reason it's not going to get a kill is because no one is going to answer it at this point in the game. You see straight away, Kalista backs out of the lane, Carbon looking for another pick.
Kenzie's still hanging out, though, as Choo-Choo's ulti comes through. Warble going to get knocked up, but the lantern is good from Destiny. Minky now going to try to dive his way in, but even with his flash, he can't go too far through. Carbon goes over the wall instead. Destiny going to pop the box to peel him away, and his thresh play, this bottom lane, in fact, have looked so good this game.
Yeah, they can't catch anyone in the end. Fantastic disengage. They get the inside track to try and push down a turret, but even then, looks like Ivana going to be able to respond.
They've got Kensi. Tremor Sense is good there from Carbon. Minkian's taking to try and zone him out. Eats the chain for his troubles. And Legacy will try the turret here, but the wave clear might just be enough for Ivana.
Yeah, we'll see whether they can push them away.
Looks to arrow, lands on the Tallywhacker of all people. Kensi dives in as Porky gets the kill. Destiny is low. We'll get the double flay, but go down Gravity Field in a good spot. But Kensi gets another kill. Porky, massive ulti there and just wallops them to death. Warble going to try and play cleanup as Kensi gets a double. And Avant turned that quickly around.
Yeah, they look for Baron as well. 23 minutes into the game. What a Gnar coming through from Porky. Absolutely massive in that team fight. And once again, the arrow that started it all off.
And Tallywhacker, of all champions on Kalista, no summoners there to save him. No Mikhail's up yet quite for flying. You're not even looking at it quite yet. Ivana are going to have to peel off Baron. They're onto Minky, actually, is looking for a Quadra. We'll find Kensi another kill instead. We'll delay the Baron, so a good move in. But the Warble arrows, man, they are scary.
Yeah, smart move from Minky right there. That was definitely a Baron if he didn't contest it. Got damage down on the back line all of a sudden. If Kensi ate any stray damage from Baron, he was falling, so they back away. But that's just elongating the lead. Now out to about 4,000. And Legacy, honestly, with how their vision control was set up in the jungle, they were looking for a skirmish, not a turret siege. They just ate the arrow.
Oh, Destiny actually gives himself away to the Raptor camp in case anybody else is coming. But Carbon says a quick hello and then backs away from it as Porky, nope, not going to come in to clear the waves. Actually, Warble, by the looks of things, wants the Raptors. As Destiny, he's having a hard time here with the Raptor camp.
Yeah, that, I actually wanted him to continue. That was an epic one-on-one, and I think Destiny might have lost in the end.
Maybe.
But Warble came to the rescue.
The Raptors are very scary. Warble finally going to rescue his support this time around. Usually works the other way here as Avant looking for the dragon that's up in a minute as well. But Legacy, smart rotations, honestly, keeping themselves in the game. They're a smart team. They know when to take their advantages, when to take their trades, and they'll get a free turret here.
Yeah, so they'll able to be pick up bottom. They will get the recall in time as well. So completely agree. Good map movement to get into the bottom lane. One thing I do want to point out is we mentioned a lot how efficient Tallywhacker's item build is on Kalista. Bloodthirster into Hurricane. However, he's still equal in two major items with Warble right now, who's got an Infinity Edge.
Shelby Lantern's away. Flying Jew takes chunks there from Kensi as Minky trying to dive in onto the LeBlanc. Carbon's going to follow through as well. Minky diving a little too deep. Mikhail's comes through. Destiny now going to look for a hook as Carbon. A little too deep there on top of Shelby gets altered back. Porky going to zone the rest out. Carbon's got nowhere to go. Choo-choo's over the wall on the Victor trying to poke people out. But Porky's 1v3 poking things up here. Got a boatload of arrows into his body, but still chasing through. Arrow is good. Narolti will just miss. But Kensi dives in, gets the kill onto Rek'Sai. Choo-choo's is far too low. Minky's dead to Porky. Gragas going to get the next kill. And Avant keep coming up with these ridiculous team fights.
Yeah, Porky just absorbed so many key cooldowns in that fight, went low, but then got the perfect transform. Once again, they pick up a 3-for-0. And on a knife's edge, Destiny nearly fell down. One laser miss Warble. He would have been chunked out and not able to fight, but chips falling in their direction. Kensi incredibly fed right now. And they're just coming up with slight win after slight win.
Kensi is so sneaky. I swear, every champion he plays, whether it's an assassin like LeBlanc or more of a wave clear control champion like Cho'Gath, he just finds a way to get himself kills. As Shelby might actually be the one dead here onto Tally as Carbon flanks around onto Porky, interrupts the hop there with the Umbaro. Warble trying to kite away, and Porky might think about going back in, transforms into Mega Gnar as Shelby. He's got a little too much trouble here coming in. Ren will give Tally a kill, but a fine trade there for Ivan.
But you saw the problem with the comp. That just took three members, half of mid lane with no turrets, to kill the Gragas. there's no way if this gets into a 5v5 teamfight, Tally has enough damage to be able to chunk them out. And it looks like they're setting up to bait a Baron because honestly, there's nothing else they can do.
Oh, Porky could be in trouble. Nah, gonna get knocked up by the ulti. Good bait from Legacy, but Porky can't quite finish the Lantern. Dies mid-air to the laser.
Yeah, got Warble's heal out as well, so now maybe they can start up the Baron. Got good secure coming through there from the Kalista. Hawkshot will be useful here to be able to scout it up, but it's a 3v5 still. They're gonna make him check it.
Kensi gonna try and dive through. Avant have tools here. A bit scary for Legacy to do this Baron.
For Legacy.
This is, yeah. You said it there, Legacy. They're in the Baron, though. Arrows are through. Shelby not there in time, so Avant needs to go in. Now the hook lands onto Baron, of all things, but it's secured by Legacy, and Avant have to run away.
Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't throw the Ash Arrow in. Tally's on the back, and they will.
Yeah, throw it now. Tally eats the arrow. Kensi dives on his face, and Warble gets the kill.
And that's what I can't believe they didn't do when they were doing Baron, because that would have been a four-man distort instead of just taking out Tallywhacker. Look how fed Kensi is right now. Instead, they give up Baron for and a 2-for-1 in Legacy's favor. That's probably stalled out the game for maybe long enough for Legacy to get a window.
And I think for me, the key member of Legacy in this game, it's Minkuel.
Yeah, he needs to be able to get to a point where he can frontline against Warble, because right now everyone else is eating Ash Arrows apart from Minky.
I mean, Minky doesn't care. He's going to shrug off most of those slows. He actually did go Merc Tread, so managed to skip the Ninja Tab that he might have wanted for the lane. Avant are going to look for a tower here. They might just get it, but the wave clear is good here from Choo-Choo's especially, and with the Baron up minions, Legacy hold on.
Yeah, and you know QSS is now finished up for Tallywhacker. That arrow play will no longer work on him, although it's probably not going to help him against Kensi, who's ridiculously huge. So there are things in Legacy's favor starting to stack up. I don't know whether anyone can deal with Minky split pushing right now. He's an absolute monster because on the other side of the map, you see the Porky, he's going defensive items for team fights. So there are things that Legacy can do to prolong this game. It's just that they've put themselves in a very large hole once again.
They have, and I like that Avant, I like that Warble, excuse me, is going for that last whisper, knows he has to get through the armor there of Minky, who's already got his Randuin's. Legacy's starting to feel a bit more confident. Get aggressive now. Get those wards down, because they know they find someone with the Umbara, with Minky, and with Choo-Choo's damage, they'll get a very easy kill.
Oh, 100%. The thing about Victor, like we mentioned all of his weaknesses in the pregame, if he's anywhere near Warble, like looks at Warble at this point in the game, Warble dies.
Yes. And I think Choo-Choo's now, especially with that QSS finish, he's the big arrow target. So it's going to be a pretty curious standoff between Ash and Victor here, which is a bit of a weird thing to say given the lanes that they started the game in. But Avant, they know what their win conditions are. They're trying to push down a couple more towers. But you mentioned those Baroned up minions. Legacy just going to stop every offense at this stage.
Yeah, they certainly are. And, you know, removing Baron also removes a part of the map that you can bait a fight over as Minky looking at Destiny.
Gets grabbed there. Shelby coming in. Knockup does land from the body slam, but nothing left here. Lantern out. Goodbye. Shelby says, all right. Didn't really fancy that, as it turns out. Sorry, Minky.
Juice caught someone.
That's not good. Warble actually is the one that's gotten caught. So very bad stuff as Porky. Almost Mega Gnar now, but he's going to get locked up by about a million CCs. Fate's call, got Nautilus back into range. They're trying to riddle Porky with arrows. They slow him down with the Ren. The Gnar will get them out of the way for now. But Choo-Choo's coming through, slow from the gravity field. Another Lantern, but Carbon gets in there now. Kensi diving into the backside, but can't finish onto Tallywhacker. Flaytho comes back onto Carbon. He's almost dead. Ulti there from Shelby, trying to move them back into the tower. And Kensi is going to get dove, but Shelby's going to peel for him. LeBlanc dancing everywhere, gets a kill onto Tally somehow. Avant, despite losing her AD carry, might turn it around as Drew. He's locked up. Kensi again for the kill. Gonna make it more there. Carbon comes back in from the fountain. Double knock up there as he gets exhausted. Avant forced to move away. And Porky stops the shenanigans. Carbon's caught by a hook. And that was a... the arrow takes out Carbon.
Yeah, so they take out two members. No, Porky didn't die. So they take out one member. They chase for too long. Tally tanked two turret hits there. That's how he died on the back end of that fight. A little bit unfortunate. And Choo's was There was a long time there that Choo's actually couldn't throw out full spell rotations because he didn't have the mana for it. In the end, you saw... All right, let's take another look at it. So Porky, he lives. Kensi does a lot of damage. Fantastic hook coming through here, and it's just an elongated team fight. Fantastic ultimate shoves everyone back in, and they prioritize Kensi, which is the right call. But right here, you see Tally, he takes the turret shot and falls down from there. They needed to just immediately get out of the fight because you see Choo's mana incredibly low. This is the last spell he can effectively use. From there, he can't use anymore. Kensi actually misses the double to Storm. Carbon tries to save it. But look at this whole time that Choo's is doing nothing. He's just running in and out, no mana, can't affect it. Porky gets back in. Ash Arrow snipes it out. Now they have positional advantage around the Dragon area, though Legacy cleaning that up. They need a blue buff on their mid laner.
Yeah, everyone's back here, and they do need that blue, but the Dragon will spawn. No chance for the blue just yet here for Choo Choo's. And Avant going to get themselves on top of the objective. Might look to take it away, but Legacy have five men strong. They're looking to fight, maybe.
Yeah, I think the target right now is actually the support player. Ju can't eat the arrow because he is very susceptible to being taken down, and they rely on his CC a lot to be able to continue through these fights. Being able to peel, being able to hook up Kensti is huge. So Ju, even though he should be one of the... Wow.
Running in there, Chelby gets caught by a hook, but Kensti in the backlines trying to dive in onto a carry. Doesn't quite hit. Tally eats an arrow, but gets out of it with the QSS. Now Porky getting chased down. Kensti reflanks again there, and it's two different sides here. Avant trying to sort of corral Legacy, but Legacy sticking together, five-man strong. Porky gets chunked out, knocked up by the Fates Call. Will go down there to Choo Choo's, and that's one kill. That's all Legacy need.
Fought around the transformation perfectly. He was exhausted there, the Gnar. Couldn't get in for the huge ultimate. In the end, Legacy come away with a kill. They'll grab the Dragon.
Might have to be careful while exiting the pit, though, but Dragon should go over. No steal even attempted there by Chelby, as the Wrangler will take it out here. So three Dragons now for Legacy. That fifth Dragon was stopped. They would have had it right now if they'd taken all of them. But instead, we just sort of reset, and Legacy still about 5,000 gold behind.
Yeah, but their composition scales incredibly well. Victor, he's getting stronger as the game goes on. Kensti will eventually fall off as all these QSSs and magic resist comes through for the team. Choo Choo's consistent damage is just way too strong. And Tally, now that he's got that QSS, we see he's much safer on the back end of the fight. I really think that Ju is the target they need to get rid of. He's a little bit HP tanky, but no resistances right now. They can delete him off the map really quickly if they prioritize him, and that's a lot of the catch potential gone from Legacy.
It's an easy pick as well, because support's always wonder off
the
ward.
He was at the front. He was like steamrolling in.
He was ready. He was just begging to be arrowed to the face. And it's crazy to me that we look at Kensi's damage in particular. There's actually no locket yet here for Legacy. Ju hasn't started one. Carbon's, I think, working towards one now, but it'll be a little late from this stage given that he does need to get a little bit more gold. Mikhail's done for Destiny means Warble can stay safe. Kensi may be here as well as Chelby. Sees a flying Ju come through and has to back away.
Yeah, they don't want to use any cooldowns right now on Ju. They once again had... So
waiting for Kensi. Yeah, even Ju's getting hooked, which would have been a great pick. Normally, I mean, can't quite get him yet.
Yeah, so they're baiting around Baron. Currently, vision control is in Avant's favor. Have to see whether they're able to maintain it, though. And Minky, he's still in the top lane trying to get some farm.
I mean, he's been slowly but surely farming up away, still consistently ahead of Porky, despite all of the aggression and pressure that Avant have been dishing out this whole game long. Minkywell's only going to get tankier. Warble's going to find more and more difficulty in keeping Aurelia off him despite the good damage and damage items that he has. Porky's very tanky as well, so Legacy do have to select their targets appropriately. It's a curious fight here. We're going to look for the Baron fight eventually. It is back up. Legacy around it. Looking for a team fight. Porky going to face check here. Rage is down. Lantern will move through, but Hop does come in instead. He's now Mega, though. Avant might be able to fight around this. Gnarl's going to get them in. Mickey's going to eat the arrow, but Choo Choo's goes down instantly as Kensti dives into the backline. Tally hits a hook, but he QSSs it off, and Kensti just going to dive back in once more. Exhaust down as Chelby gets a double. Warble flashing forward aggressively as Mickey hits a hook. Tally goes down, and Avant very well played.
Yeah, and you know, Chelby got the triple kill, but credit to Kensti. His target prioritization, fantastic in that fight. They will be able to push through, be able to pick up at least an inhibitor for themselves. And Avant-Garde with a very good fight coming through, and they just went for one too many picks onto Porky.
I mean, yeah, it looks like it. He's just so tanky as Avant. We'll break the brace and get the picks, but I agree with you. Kensti there, massive here, and you know, it was Warble's early arrows that sort of got them ahead and got them this nice lead here. But it's been the density combo all day long. These hooks and the target selection from Kensti have been on point every single team fight.
Yeah, Destiny definitely deserves some credit as well. 1, 2, and 15 coming up massive for his team. They will be able to grab Baron off the back of this, but it looks like Legacy still want to fight.
Yeah, that Baron died so swiftly, so no steal chance here. Minky's in the area, actually ported down here to try and get them off the Baron again here. But instead, Avant will finally get their first Baron of the game.
Yeah, so they get the Baron. Minky dodged the volley, he dodged the barrel. House hit him in the end.
It's always the house that
gets you. It's always the house.
Well, Minky, pretty tanky at this stage. So I can probably even shrug off a house or a piece of house being thrown at him. Legacy now going to move down towards the mid lane again. They've got tools, they've got plenty of damage, but they're just falling a bit behind in gold. About 8,500, 8,000 gold behind right now. I guess the lead's probably not that bad at this stage, given that we're quite late, almost 40 minutes into this game. But Legacy have not found a single team bet they've liked.
Yeah, they certainly haven't. They got the last one where they were able to catch Gnar in mini Gnar form, but that time when they caught Porky, it was just getting a right evolution timing through there. So he was able to get the huge Gnar ultimate, which really set up everything else. And they've started pushing in top lane now with that Baron up minions. Super creeps in the mid lane as well, so someone's going to have to stay over there to deal with them. Teleport advantage. They've pretty much got everything in their favor to be able to chip down this base turret.
Well, that turret's absolutely dead. So sixth turret of the game will go to Avan. That's all of the outers and the tier twos now felled. So with the Baron up cannon, it's just time for these inhibitor turrets.
Yeah, Blue Elixir now on Kensty as well. He wants to try and get in there, get more damage in. Nice hook.
Yeah, onto Karba, just a bit of poke. Kensty actually, respectable poke champion on this LeBlanc sitting at level 18. With that, lots of CDR coming through. And even Warble can throw in some volleys as well. And if anyone's caught themselves out, they're going to eat a nice big arrow to the face.
Yeah, they certainly are. And, you know, there's actually really good wave clear on the side of Legacy right now. They've got Choose to be able to deal with it all. Very big anti-dive threats in the Nautilus, in the Rek'Sai. So, surprised we haven't seen something cute like a Banner of Command as Kensty eats a hook.
Oh, that's not good news. Tallywhacker coming in. The kill is there as Choo Choo takes him out, but Destiny hooks him on. Porky gonna dive in there. Can't find the ulti though. Chelby kind of throws him into disarray, but they don't have enough. Choo's gonna eat the arrow, but that's just gonna get Porky out safely.
Chelby on the backside, he's caught out as well.
Yeah, trying to run away, gets the lantern out there, so Avant might lose the minimum, never mind. Chelby gonna get grabbed up for a kill there from Tally, and Legacy finally getting the fight they wanted.
And they got it at the perfect moment. Look at the Nexus, turrets under fire. One more wave and they couldn't have fought when they did, so the catch on Kensty coming at exactly the right moment.
And a dragon coming up soon as well. Legacy might be able to secure their fourth and force Avant to fight them on the fifth year. And by the time that rolls around, they're going to have a nice lead as Warble's actually come through. Carbon will face check Destiny, but Minky Whale's found it instead. Lantern plus Face of the Mountain going to keep him safe, though. And Legacy, they can't afford to hang around for too long.
And Porky 2v1's on the back
line. Oh, he's found it. Megan has come through. He's actually 1v3. Goes down to Tallywhacker, who finally has his last whisper. And a couple of mistakes in a row give Legacy a dragon.
Yeah, so in the end, they will definitely take that trade. Able to pick up the fourth dragon of the game as well. That one definitely going through. And Legacy, once again, veteran team. They just come up with the goods when they look like they're out of the game. Twice in one game now, stalling out for as long as possible. The door is slowly shutting, but they're keeping it ajar.
They are just keeping it peeking open there. And this was Avant's story in their first game this week. Fell behind, managed to be the veteran team and find the late game team fights and win out towards the end of the game. Legacy, they were known for comebacks back in 2014, might have just clawed their way back into this one. 40 minutes in, still about 6,500 gold ahead for Avant, but that gold difference is starting to mean less and less as the game drags on.
Yeah, it certainly is. You see maxed out items now for Kensty. Choose has nearly joined him on that front. Ash waiting on one more item before Warble will join her there. And that fifth dragon is what this game has now become about, because with four, every other dragon that spawns, Avant have to respond to the team fight, and Minky Whale is getting bigger and bigger as the game goes on, going to be able to dive Ash. You saw last team fight, Warble wanted nothing to do with Minky, so this game is getting incredibly difficult for Avant as it goes late.
Looks to be as red buff does get taken away there by Warble. I guess the other thing to look at with that fifth dragon now looming for Legacy as they claim the fourth, Baron's going to be back up between those timers as well. So it's almost now a game of a fight between the two mages. Baron is good for both teams. I think Avant in particular would like it to break the base here. But that fifth dragon now so super important for Legacy and Avant. They're trying to break this base, but Legacy have been holding on, although this inhib is the one that's open.
Yeah, but they're funneled into a choke. They need to be careful of Jew.
Porky needs a little bit more rage there as well, just getting the poke in. Carbon actually gets hooked up. Flay will miss there from Destiny. A little short there trying to get Carbon. But poor Warble, he's actually playing in the backside. Minky gets grabbed up. Will get poked out as well. Ulti used by Chelby as Porky might be enough of a threat to give them this inhibitor. Gonna eat the gravity field, get stunned up, but Warble finally able to get in safely. Choo-choos. Lucky to dodge that hook, but doesn't quite hit him.
Yeah, they're trying to look for an engage off the retreat, but they won't find it.
They don't have the disengage ultimates, actually. They have to be careful. Destiny gonna get grabbed there by Jew. Teleport there coming in for Minky as well. Juju's gets the first kill onto Thresh. Minky maybe a little too deep here. Kensty has to get out of the way. Chelby and Porky nice and tanky, even in the mini now there. And Carbon comes back in. What was that as Chelby gets grabbed up and Fate's called at the same time. Kensty gonna dive back in, but can't find anyone. Ulti lands in there for Ashe onto Carbon. Ju gonna get aggressed on. He's tanky, but not that tanky. Chelby comes in. Kensty around the back. Takes out someone as Gragas gets flying. Ju still running in for the damage. Minky and Chu's are far too low. Warble slays Tally. Kill from the Gragas ulti. Takes out Minky and Avant. Finally turn it around one last time. Kensty finds Choo-Choo's there as well, and that's going
to
be game.
That was 100% worth. Gets rid of all of the wave clear. They're going to be able to move through and take the game. What a team fight. One more time for Kensty. Throws his life away as the human cannonball, but that was worth.
Yep, Porky ulti onto Carbon, who's trying to shake them off the turrets. Might not be enough. Chelby actually face tanking one right now, but kills Carbon. That's going to be it there. There's no more of Legacy left to defend. And Avant, in a very back and forth game, finally come out on top.
That was a battle. And in the end, they're able to come through with a very cute pick comp. Haven't seen one in a while. But Avant make it work.
They do. And a very creative, very different comp here. Hard to pull off, very execution heavy, because they basically team fought.
That was about vision control.
It was.
And they ran it into a double sightstone composition and were able to deny enough vision in the mid game where Warble's arrow after arrow picked people off. That one of Carbon in the mid lane started that snowball running down the hill.
It did, and it looked a little shaky towards the end, but managed to execute the last few team fights and come on top of the end. We actually have a replay of the very last team fight of the game, so Spawn, take it away.
Yeah, so you saw that Flying Jew got chunked out, but he didn't die. And what that meant is the re-engage was on. You see Chelby's ultimate currently on cooldown. Jew flying after Destiny. So as we roll this one out, Destiny gets deleted. Absolutely taken off the map. And they look like they're in a good position to fight it, but they continue to kite back. Porky's in exhaustion mode. He can't get any rage. Everything going Avant's way. But we mentioned Kalista's inability to bust tanks, and she can't get through any of the priority targets right now. They continue to fight. Kensty continues to look for his window. They finally get the Ashe arrow, and right here, Kensty dives onto four members in the back line, able to take them all extremely low. And then you're running away from an Ashe Gragas. Like, that is a lot of follow-up CC. The snipe, Kensty, human cannonballs into Choo-Choo's here with the flash, able to trade his life for Kensty, Choo-Choo's, who hadn't used his ultimate in all of that, and they just come up with a very important win, you have to feel, for Avant.
Oh yeah, very important. That's going to give them actually the win for the week, I believe. We'll check in with the results of the day as well, just to see who's come out on top and who has not. We'll start off at the top of the day here. Sin and Absolute gave Sin a win, and the Chiefs still undefeated, but taking on the Direwolves.
Yeah, then Immunity ended out this week undefeated, taking down Sudden Fear, and Avant able to roll over Legacy to give them a 0-2 week.
Yeah, and Avant a 2-0 week, which is great news for Avant and really bad news for Legacy.
Yeah, it certainly is. And if you want any of those VODs or any other stats, head over to that website, oce.lolesports.com. Plenty of information there.
Yeah, plenty of great highlights for you to watch there as well. But that will wrap us up for tonight as well. We'll join us next Monday when the OPL kicks back off again. But for myself, Atlas, Rusty, Spawn, your Spawn, right?
Yeah.
Spawn and our entire live production crew, I won't make too many more mistakes, but we'll see you next week.